Yes, but we're gonna start standing up. And finding mountain pose. So letting your feet be about this width apart. And then when you get your feet about hips width apart, take a look down and notice where your feet are in space. So maybe your feet are straight on. Maybe they turn in a little bit. Maybe they turn out a little bit. And it's all good. If your foot turns out a lot, you might bring it in a little bit. Or if your foot turns in a lot, you might bring it more to center a little bit, just to bring things more to balance. But when I started practicing yoga, there was a lot of emphasis on your feet have to be 90 degrees. Well, that's not so. So we're all different. So just noticing what we have available and then making some tiny changes. So once you're here, let's pick up our toes. Spread your toes out. Feel your big toe mount. And then see if you can feel your pinky toe mount. Reach into that and the center of your heel. Nice. And then let's let the toes come down. Really nice and soft. Think about spreading your toes out here. Think about lifting your ankles towards your knees and your knees towards your hips. So the legs, especially the front of the legs, are lifting. Engage your low abdominals. Inhale, lift your heart space, lift your chest. And then also think about reaching up through the crown of your head. So our whole front body is lifting. And then think about going down the back of your head and letting it kind of descend down. So it might be a weird idea to think about this. Think about the skin relaxing down towards your neck and the backside of your shoulders relaxing down. And your glutes kind of relaxing down and feeling your heels. So think about your front body lifting and your back body descending. So front body ascending, back body descending. Let your eyes be soft here and then notice your breath. And I want you to think about your breath starting at the top of your toes, like toenails, and then it's coming up over your ankles, over your knees, up your thighs, torso, up to the crown of your head. Exhale from the crown of your head, down your back to the bottoms of your feet, under your feet, and inhale up the front of the legs. And then exhale from your crown down, and from your toes up, inhale. Inhaling up your front body, exhaling down the back body, and maybe using some imagery of a milky or smoky like substance moving up and down, if that's helpful to you. Recheck in with your feet, your legs, your posture. Notice what your mind is expressing through your face right now. Notice that you're breathing. And then just take a moment to remind yourself why you're here. Why are you here this morning? Breathe that in. Breathe it into your heart space. And then from here, we're going to let our chin drop down towards our chest and let your left ear come over towards your left shoulder. And as you inhale, bring your chin back down to your chest. Exhale, let your left ear come over towards your left shoulder. And inhale, bring it back. This next time, left ear, left shoulder. Stay here, or if it's not too much, let your left hand take your right ear. Left hand would take the right ear as the left ear is coming down towards the left shoulder. But if that's too much, don't worry, give me that hand there. It's just an option. Release your hand, let your chin come back down to your chest, bring your ears let's roll the right shoulder. Just give the right shoulder a roll. Up, back, and down here with your breath. Slow and easy here. Then let's begin to let the elbow come into this. Lifting the elbow, and then if you like, take the whole arm up and around. But if it compromises your movement, maybe you stick with the elbow. All right, the next time our right arm is up high to the sky here, stay there. We're going to lean over to the left. You might look up, you might down, forward, breathe into the right side of your body. That was where you're creating some space. And where we're creating space, then we're removing some stagnation, staleness. Press down to come on up here. Let your right hand come down. Let's heel toe our feet just a little closer. Bend your knees, bring your hands onto your knees. We're gonna make circles to the right. So go to the right. Slow and easy. Getting our ankles, our knees, our hips. Let's take one more round here. Press down to come up. Heel toe your feet a little wider than your shoulders here. Bend your knees, come into like an umpire shape. And we're gonna round the back, scoop the back up into cat pose. And then inhale, let your belly drop down, the tail and the crown come back. So just going back and forth here, nice and slow. Cat and cow from a standing position. Waving the spine. Good, one more time here. Pause in neutral. Let your hands slide down your shins here. Let your head go. You might bring your legs even wider here. Nod your head out. And let's bend and straighten the legs a few times. Bend and straighten the legs with your breath. And then hinge forward here. Let your left hand come under your face. You could definitely use a block here if you want or not. And bring your right palm onto your low back, dial your right elbow high to the sky, and if you'd like, bend your left knee. Stacking your shoulders here. Good, let's come back through neutral here. Let your head go, heel toe your feet so that they're hips width apart. Notice where your feet land in space. Press down into them, press all the way up. Exhale down the center line here, all the way to the sides. Let's inhale, take the arms up, and exhale down through the center line. Good, inhale and up. Exhale and down. Good, let's inhale up here. Let both of your arms come up, let your left hand down. We're going to take your right arm over, getting this lateral stretch. We've been here once. Press down to come up here. Let your hands come down. We're going to pick up our right heel. Pick up your right heel here. Feel your left foot on the floor. Engage your low abdominal. So it's a little shift. That the front is lifting and the back is lowering a little bit. And we're just going to float the foot up. Let's turn the ankle a few times. take our right leg back now. So step it back. Let's sweep our arms up. Relax your shoulders here. As you inhale, straighten your front leg, let your arms float down. Exhale, bend your knee, arms up. Good, we're just gonna float like this a few times. Inhaling and exhaling. Good, one more time. If you have your back heel up now, let it come down. So if it were up, you could let it come down and we'll be in warrior one. Relax your shoulders here. Let's let our hands come down to plank, but we're stepping back into downward facing. Maybe you experiment with taking your legs a little wider. Maybe you dial your heels out and your toes in, see how that feels. So being curious here. We're coming forward into high plank, or low plank even. And we're going to drop both of our knees. Drop both of your knees down and take your right leg back and your left arm. Keep your face up. Keep breathing in and out through your nose. Let your left hand come down. Slide your right knee towards your right thumb. Slide your left leg back. Now, if this shape doesn't work for your body, for your current condition, if it does, we're going to come forward. If it doesn't, come and lie on your back and hug your right knee in. And you might let it come out to the right a little bit. All right? So we always have options. Let's take one more breath here. Whichever shape you're in, we're going to meet back in all fours. So we're going to meet back in all fours, however you need to get yourself there. Press down through your left hand to take your right arm. And we're going to scoop the right arm down and through. Let the right side of your face come down to your mat. Pressing in with your left hand here. Let's take one more breath. Press down with your left hand. Coming back into all fours here. Spread your fingertips out wide. Roll your toes under hips. Go back. You can always use a blanket under your knee or fold over your mat. Maybe you bring your right hand around onto your low back if there's more room to go here. Begin to unwind, look down, heel toe your right foot so that it's more neutral. Let's roll the back toes under, lift the knees. Step together, fold forward here, let your head. Press down, rise up. down the center line. Find yourself back in mountain pose and check your feet. Where are your feet at in space now? Let's bring them back to about hips width. Feel your ankles, your knees, your hips, your chest, up through the crown of your head. And we'll think about breathing up our front body from my toenails up to the crown. Exhale down the back of your head, down the back of your neck, your shoulders, waist, hips, legs, abs, down into your heels, through the bottoms of the feet, and then inhale up your front body here. Notice what your mind is expressing through your feet. Let your breath be smooth in and out through your nose so that you can audibly hear it. Breath here. We're going to let the chin drop down to the chest and bring your right ear over towards your right shoulder and then let your chin sweep back down and right ear, right shoulder. Breathe into the left side of your neck. You might even envision that the left side of your neck has a lung in it and that you're breathing into that lung here. If you have the hand on the head, let it come on down. Sweep your chin back to your chest. Bring your ears over your shoulders. And let's begin to rotate our left shoulder, connecting it with the breath here. And then let's involve the elbow. So the rotation might become a little bit bigger. Really be curious about what you're feeling here. And then maybe you take the arm all the way up. If it isn't compromising your movement, wherever we're at in this, we're going to take our left arm straight up, reach it up, and lean over to your right. And deep breaths into the left side of your body. Let's come back. Circles to the left this time. Slow and easy movement to the left. One more round here. We're going to press down to come up. Heel, toe, our feet wider than our shoulders. Set your hips back, bring your hands onto your knees. This time, rather than doing cat and cow, let's bring opposite shoulder to opposite knee. Unless the cat and cow feels better for you, then by all means. And let's stop in the center, move into stillness, let your torso come forward, let the crown of your head come down. Come back and feel your feet here. Can you reach into your big toe mound, your pinky toe mound, and the center of the ball of your foot here? Bring your right hand under your face on your mat or on a block, bring your left hand onto your low back, and dial your left elbow towards the sky. Maybe you pick up your right heel. down through your feet. Inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, down through the center. Good. Inhale, take it up. Deep breath. Exhale, down. Inhale, let's take it up and let your right hand come down. Left arm's going to come over. Press down here, come up. Come back into your mountain pose. Think about taking a breath up the front side of your body and down the back side. And then we'll pick up our left heel. So pick up the left heel, and if it's okay, bring it out in front. Maybe your hands come on your waist. Let's turn the ankle a few times. Turning it a few times in the other direction. And then we'll let that move into stillness, bend to the standing knee, take that left leg back. Come onto the ball mound if that's okay. So the ball mound for the back foot, so the heel is up. And if this is really wobbly, keep walking your right foot over to the right or your left foot over to the left to broaden your base. Let's sweep the arms up, deep inhale. Here, as we exhale, we're gonna straighten the legs and let the arms go down. And then we'll inhale, bend. Good. And exhale, straighten. Times just like this. And then this next time that we're in the crescent lunge here, let's stay here, relax your shoulders, and then dial your back heel down. So that turns it into warrior one. Although some people call the heel up warrior one too. It's all good, it's just a shape one. Your face soft, keep breathing here. We're gonna let the hands come down, pick up the heels, step back into downward facing. Walk it out here a little bit. Let's make our way into all fours. Once you're in all fours, we're taking our left leg back and our right arm forward. Left leg back, right arm. Let your right hand come down. Now this is where we're gonna slide the left knee forward, if that's okay for your unique body. If it's not, roll over onto your back and hug your knee in. So left knee's coming forward, our left glute is coming towards our left heel, and then you might come forward more. Feel free to make a little movement, maybe a little swaying side to side or forward. These poses aren't meant to be static. Let's take another cycle of breath here and make our way back into all fours. Once we're in all fours, we're going to take our left arm up high to the sky and thread it through. So we'll be resting on the left side of the face. Right hand is pressing down. Think about stacking your shoulders here. Yeah, you can bring your right hand around to your low back, go towards your left hip crease. If there's a variation that you know that I don't offer, please feel free to experiment and be curious with those. We'll take one more breath here. We're going to press
down through the right hand. Bring the left arm back to neutral. Spread your fingertips. Roll your toes under. Take your hips back and up. Plug your humerus bones, your upper arm bones, into your sockets here. And then hug your front rib cage to your back rib cage. And think about dialing your inner thighs back behind you. Now let's soften our knees, look forward. We're going to step our left foot outside of our right, our left foot outside of our left hand. Because if we took it outside of our right foot, that would be pretty spectacular. Let's let the right knee come down. If anybody wants to do that, you can go right ahead. And then we're going to keep pressing down through our right hand, and left hand can come on the thigh, and we're just turning and stacking. Let's bring it back to neutral. You might heel toe your foot back into center. Frame the foot. We'll pick up that back knee. Fold forward. Let your head go. Relax. Press down to come up. Sweep all the way up. Let your palms come to touch. Exhale down the center. Inhale, sweeping up. And maybe you think about your reason for being here, and scooping that up and bringing it down towards your heart with these movements. Find yourself in mountain pose. Come back to noticing your ankles, your knees, your hips, your shoulders, your ears, the crown of your head. For the next few cycles of breath, think about breathing up the front side of your body and breathing down the back side. You could use a visual of maybe a milky or cloudy type of substance, or maybe something completely different. Let them blink open. Let's bring our feet a little closer together. Inhale through your nose. Take your arms up. Let your left hand seal your right forearm. And lean over to your left. Good. Come back through neutral here. Let your hands come together. Heel toe your feet just a little wider here. We're going to bring our hands to our heart center. And we're going to take our left arm forward and our right arm back. And inhale back to neutral. And exhale, left hand forward, right hand back. Good. And back to neutral. Really move slow and controlled. You can get some deep core work here by moving slowly with control. Let's do one more time here. Reaching forward, reaching back. Come back to neutral. Your hands come to your heart center. Let's let the hands come down and bring them onto your waist. Float your right heel up, maybe the knee lifts. And then if your knee is up, notice what's happening in your hips. Is your belly coming forward and your rear end going back? That's what happens to me. So I try to neutralize it here.
Soften your standing knee. We're going to step this right leg back here. Sweep your arms and relax your face. Good. We're going to let our hands come down to frame our foot. Janelle, you might want to bring your hands inside of your foot. So we're either framing our foot or hands inside of the foot. And we're going to hinge forward and let that right leg lift high to the sky. Let the crown of your head drop down towards your mat. Bend your left knee. Let your right foot tap down to your mat now. Let your hands frame your foot. Bring your right knee down. Heel toe your left foot over to the left a bit. Press down through your right hand. Let your left hand come onto your left thigh. Maybe you roll onto pinky toe edge. Sweep it out to the left or float it out. If you have your leg floating up, let it come on down. Press it down through your left hand to bring your and then let your right hand come down. We're going to sweep our shins around to one side or the other and come and lie down on your back. So bring your glutes a little closer to your heels. Press down through the backs of your hands. And on your next breath, lift your hips up into bridge pose. And then come down. And then lift your hips up into bridge pose. And come down. Good. Once you're back down here, we're going to hug our right knee close to the chest. And then make some movement with this leg. Begin to circle it a few times in one direction. And then a few times in the other direction. From here, we're going to let our right knee move in the direction of our right elbow. So it's opening out to the right here. And then bring your right hand onto your calf, your shin, your ankle, your pants leg, or the bottom of your foot. We're moving towards half happy baby pose. So it might look like this shape I'm making up here. It might look like this. If you feel enough sensation here, then by all means, stay there. From here, cross your right ankle over your left knee.
So we're making a figure four here. Keep your right foot active. Let's lift our left foot up off of the mat. If this is enough, stay here. Maybe you interlace behind your thigh. Hands could come behind your left thigh. Or maybe over your shin. It's going to be safer for your knee behind your thigh. Your shoulders and your jaw here. Make sure that you're breathing mindfully in and out through your nose. So we're going to come up to seated by whatever means necessary. So you could rock yourself up by taking your left leg up and kind of just sweeping up. Or maybe you use your hands, whatever you need to do there. And we'll let the sole of our right foot come to the mat. And you know, you might want to keep it here. Yeah. So just pressing down here. Get tall in your spine. And let's let the left arm take the right leg. Let your right hand come around you. Keep your face soft. Your legs, however, you need to get to standing in front of you. Coming back into mountain pose and going up all the way from your feet to the crown of your head. Let the front body feel as if it's ascending, as if it's lifting, and the back body descending. As if it's moving down. For the next few breaths, think about inhaling from the tops of your toes to the crown of your head, and exhaling from the crown of your head towards the bottoms of your toes. Exhale down through the center line. Inhale. Exhale. Keep going just like this. Inhaling up, thinking about whatever brought you to class here, drawing it down to your heart. One more time here. Let's take it up, and this time we're going to let our right hand seal our left forearm as we lean over to our right. Come on back through neutral here. Let your arms float back down. Mountain pose, bring your hands onto your waist. Let's lift the left heel here. And then notice what happens in the torso. So maybe your torso wants to come forward or lean back. Try to stack everything up here. Press down through your right foot a little more and up through the crown of your head. We're going to soften our standing knee and take our left foot back into lunge. Relax your shoulders. Let's dive the back heel down for warrior one. Keeping your face soft.
breath moving. Let's let our hands come down inside of our right foot. Drop your back knee down. Press into your left hand. Let your right hand come on to the right knee. Let your right knee open up to the ground. Bringing it back through to neutral here. Let your right knee, your left knee. We're taking our left arm here, threading the needle. So our left cheek will come down to the mat. And again, maybe we come into a different variation this time. Maybe you float your right leg up or move your hand in a different position. Your right leg, if you have it up, press down through your right hand to make your way back into table pose here. Round your back. Come through neutral. We're going to sweep our shins to one side or the other so we can come to lie down on our back. Once you're lying down here on your back, bring your heels a little closer to your glutes. Arms down by the sides, walk your fingertips down, shoulder blades together. This time, not only are we going to lift the hips, but we're going to float the arms as well. And then come down. Inhaling, lifting hips, floating the arms up. Giving a squeeze at the top, coming down. This next time, keep the arms up, keep the hips up. Relax your shoulders, relax the back of your head. And then lift your heels and begin to roll down in slow motion. Let your heels come down. Pick up your left foot. Hug your left knee in. We're just going to begin to circle a few times in one direction. Circle a few times in the other direction. Notice if there's any clunkiness or interesting sounds that come about as we move the hip joint. And then we're going to move to stillness. We're going to let the movement become stillness. Let your left knee move in the direction of your left elbow. And maybe you stay here with your hand on your shin. For many, the inner thigh is tight on human beings, this is certainly enough. Maybe you bring your hand onto your pants leg or the bottom of your foot, bringing the ankle over the knee. So this is half happy baby. From here, we're going to cross our left ankle over our right knee. And you might stay right here, just kind of lean your knee open in my direction. Or you could bring your right foot out.
back of the mat, interlacing your hands behind your right thigh or over your right shin. So we're going to make our way to seated. If you'd like to sweep your right leg up towards the sky, and just kind of feel that little leverage to make your way up, however you need to get there. We're going to keep that right leg extended, left foot's coming to the floor. So it might be outside your foot, it might be inside, I'm sorry, it might be outside of your leg or inside of your leg, either way works. But press down so that we're getting more length in the spine. Wrap your right arm around. Left hand comes down and around behind. And press it down to find more length in your spine. Relax your Let's let the knees come back together here. Bring your palms onto your kneecaps. Let's begin to make some small circles to the right. And then take it around the other way. Begin to make your circles and opposite direction. Easy does it. Let the movement become stillness. Hug your knees in close. If you need to take your knees wide, by all means do that. We're going to hold on to our shins, our ankles, or the bottoms of our feet. Bring your nose towards your knees here. Lift your head and shoulders. Good, good, good. I saw you coming. Thank you so much, John. Relax your shoulders. Relax the back of your head down. Walk you through a little self-adjustment that hopefully feels really nice here for you. So keeping your feet where they are for right now, I'd like you to
could take your hands and interlace them behind the nape of your neck.
So it's kind of like, recliner, football watching mode. Not that I watch football, but.
So let your pinkies come right to the nape of your neck at the bottom of your hairline and just begin to slide your hands up over your skull bone, the occipital bone, up through your hair. And then once you're there, let your arms float down either by your sides or on your belly, whatever feels right for you, whatever feels natural and comfortable for you. Relax your jaw. And if you have a ponytail in that causes your head to go one side or the other, you might want to just move that so that you can rest on the center of the back of your head. And then tucking a shoulder blade under yourself and then another. You might think of making an air pillow for the back door of your heart here. If this feels nice on your back to have your knees bent like this, stay like this. Or you could always extend your legs out into the prone position. Extend it out, or maybe you lie. Do what feels best for your body and what's going to allow you to be the most comfortable. So scanning from the top of your head down to your toes, and we've done that throughout class today. And softening and relaxing wherever that needs to happen. The next time that you are inhaling, squeeze all of your muscles to the bones. So think about squeezing your arm bones, your glutes, your facial muscles. And as you exhale, letting it go, and you might softly let that exhale go out through your mouth. And then inhale, squeezing your muscles to the bones. And exhaling, releasing, letting the breath go, letting the muscles go. And you might do this one more time. Inhaling and squeezing and squeezing and squeezing and squeezing. And then exhaling and letting that go. So we can actually feel what relaxation feels like. Tend to whatever you need to be comfortable here. And then just being the curious observer of yourself breathing, of yourself relaxing physically. Thank you.
there's no hurry here. We have time. Letting that go out through your exhale. So